Hello and welcome to the Divya Sharman Show with me, Divya Sharman. How many of you still remember the Bollywood numbers like Ramba Ho, Hari Om Hari, Koi Yaha Nache Nache, Tu Mujhe Jaan Se Bhi Pyara Hai and Disco 82? How many of you are still tuned to the catchy beats of Jab Chhaye Mera Jadoo and the melodious romantic number Tumhara Pyar Chahiye Mujhe Jeene Ke Liye? Frankly, these are songs that will stay glued to many like me who have grown up listening to these peppy numbers, all picturized on the sensual and stunning Kalpana Iyer. So welcome again and let's together chat with Kalpana Iyer as she walks down her memory lane to the days when she ruled the film world as the only dancing queen. Hello from Brussels and thank you so much for coming to my show.
Hi, Divya. Thank you for having me in your show. As a matter of fact, I've got some friends in Brussels. Okay. And yes, I do. And feels wonderful talking to you. Let's see where this goes now from here.
You know, this morning I woke up to your WhatsApp message reminding me about our scheduled chat today. And this just got me to respect you a lot more because aapko yaad dilane ki zimmedari to meri thi. So tell me, even earlier during your shoot days, did you always respect time and punctuality?
This is a very big keeda with me even now. I have a very big thing about punctuality. And they say that most South Indians are very punctual. I don't know about all that. But I do know that I've not interacted with many people who didn't respect time when I was a child. I mean, the entire family believed in being punctual, like even going to school also. When I started working, when I started doing stage shows and my modeling career and whatever, everybody knew that they could set their watch according to my arrival because I was never 1 minute late. I will be 5 minutes early, but never 1 minute late.
You have featured in more than 100 films. You have done television and have also been a successful model. But there's something more to this which many might not be aware of. That you were Miss India runner-up in 1978 and then had represented India in the Miss World contest. So how was that experience?
The timeline of the Miss World and the Miss India thing is a little off, Divya. It is 1976 I was... Miss India first. Okay. I was a model already. I had already participated in a couple of beauty contests, local beauty contests and stuff like that. Miss Neptune, Miss Navy Queen and blah, blah, blah. And I'm not running them down in any way. I'm just trying to move to the conversation we are having. And 1975, I did all that. And in 1976, I was Miss India. I represented India in the Miss Teenage Intercontinental. It was held in Aruba. And there I was a finalist and I won the award of the most popular candidate. And after that, when I came to India, I continued modeling and stuff like that. And that particular year, there was no Miss India contest as such. So I went again to the Miss World in 1978. So which means I've participated in two international beauty contests. And at the Miss World, I did very well because up until that point, what used to happen is that South Africa used to send two contestants. So the Indian, there was a rule that if two girls will come, the Indian girl will not participate. So the year I went, whether it was luck or whatever, the South African contestants didn't come. So I could participate in the contest because before me also lovely girls have gone. But unfortunately, South Africa's ladki aati thi, so they couldn't. And when I participated, I could participate and I did very well. The press was kind to me. I was a finalist.
Your first film, Manokamna, which was a Rashtri production, had you as a lead heroine and one of the most popular songs till date, Tumhara Pyar Chahiye, was picturized on you. So back then, had you realized how fortunate you were?
I have always said that I'm very blessed, Divya. In which way? See, first and foremost, I began work as a child with no training or nothing. Dancing just happened in my life. I not trained in anything at all. Absolutely nothing. We couldn't afford it. And I didn't think that I was in any position to even turn around and say, I want to go to a dance class. I started working early. I started doing stage shows early. The money was helpful. Everything just like, it sort of worked for me. It's just this that, you know, they say sometimes, you know, necessity is the mother of invention. I just happened that I could dance, and then it was paying me and it was helping the situation, and I started getting work, and popularity suited my temperament. I was very outspoken. I was easy to get along, and I made friends fast in my work. And I was, yes, I was also a little insecure. Not little, quite a bit insecure. But when it came to work, the insecurity just vanished. Because there was something about the way people accepted me, people took me on. And a lot of good people played a big part in what I am today and what I was then. Because when you're very raw, you can be taken advantage of and misunderstood.
Yeah.
And but I, in this also, somewhere, there's been huge, thank you, God.
Coming back to your film, Manokamna, this first big break could have got you many more films as a lead heroine. So was it Josh, Hosh or Dev Saab's aura that got you to sign his film for just one dance?
Everything. It was Josh and Hosh and Dev Saab's aura and my own. I will do what I want attitude. I'm not listening to anybody else. My instincts will work for me. Maine ye karna hai, I will do this. And ab tak ki jo safar hai, wo bhi to maine khud hi decide kiya tha. Except for my mother. I didn't have a secretary or anybody. My mother couldn't come with me everywhere. But my mother was the only support I had. Who probably did whatever she could. She was very innocent. As in, she wasn't a very savvy work person. Like, she didn't know anything about anything. So, it was a simple lady. So, with her guidance, whatever little I could understand was, hey, you're doing what you're doing and you're not doing a bad job. So, decide for yourself.
Okay.
So, and when Dev Saab spoke, he was such a charming, I mean, wonderful person. And he said it to me very nicely. And the way he said it to me was is something that still rings in my ear. He said, my dear girl, will you dance in my film? And I'm like, excuse me, sir? And he said, will you? And I'm like, yeah, I mean, what? He said, yes, no. I said, yes. And so that's it. And when you meet such a wonderful person and he doesn't beat around the bush, he said, there's already a lady in the song. And you just, I said, I don't care. And then everyone was stumped. Hey, what are you doing? And I'm like, it's okay. But that move worked. And on the sets of Lootmar, my life changed.
The song Jab Chhaye Mera Jadoo, penned by Amit Khanna, was an instant hit.
Yes. The song was a beautiful song.
So tell me, how was it working with Dev Saab? Any anecdotes that you can recollect?
For me, anecdote, Lootmar itself is an anecdote. With Dev Saab being the hero of the show. I mean, no way. I mean, not a soul can say that there was ever a dull moment. I thoroughly enjoyed myself. And he treated me so beautifully. So beautifully.
He was truly a gem. I remember during my Channel V days, I would often go and chat with him at his Pali Hill office. And he was full of life and had the best of anecdotes to share.
I haven't seen a more energetic human being. I mean, he was so full of energy and good vibes and positivity, and he wouldn't stand in one place. I mean, he was so active. And I would just keep looking at him.
I remember you had once mentioned that Lootmar was very lucky for you.
It was. On the sets of Lootmar, on the very next day, Chetan Saab came, I sang Kudrat. So, my song Chhodo Sanam happened there. Then, the next day after that, Bombay Ka Maharaja producer Iqbal Singh came and I did the title song. Then, after that, Savan Kumar Tak Saab, I did Sajan Ki Saheli. Then, after that, I met Anand. Sagar, and I did Hari Om Hari. So there you are.
I have a couple of friends who have worked with you at different stage of your career. Narendra ji, who was the sound recordist for Kudrat, Arman and Hum Saath Saath Hain.
Oh my God, he's such a lovely, lovely, lovely person.
Yeah, so he thinks of you as a very straightforward and grounded person.
First and foremost though, Narendra ji is such a gem. Such a darling. I'll never forget his voice. Lights, sound, everything was like so powerful and so beautifully articulate. Wonderful person, wonderful person.
He was also telling me about this one film success party where despite wearing a sari, you had happily removed your sandals and gotten dancing only to be joined by many. Can you recollect that?
I am not really a party person, but I had to go to a lot of places because it was expected of me. You know? And other than that, also, I used to participate by going and then I used to get chabi marod. Mujhe koi chabi mar deta tha na, I used to get very carried away. Like this thing about chappal nikal ke Kalpana ne dance kiya, it's very believable. Ye ho sakta hai. So there's really no point in my even trying to say, oh, really, then? No. It is positively happened. I don't remember where. And then please, when you meet him or you speak to him, convey to him and tell him I wish him well. I really do.
Another friend of mine, Dharmesh Darshan, was recollecting the iconic song Pardesi Pardesi from his film Raja Hindustani, in which you hadn't danced much, but it had emoted you as a brilliant actress.
It does. It's true. I'll never forget that Dharmesh came to me at the time. I'm not very busy in the movies as such, but I was very busy with television. Very, very busy with television. But when he came to meet me, the way he explained this dance, it is a memory I cherish. Because there are very, very few people who have even bothered to explain to a dancer what is the dance all about? Why is that dance being picturized? What is the reason it's being added to the film? What are the pros? What are the cons? Why is it being said the way it's being said? And the way he articulated the entire thing, the sequence, the segment, the way it's going to be done, it is a memory in my heart. And when you said Dharmesh, if you saw my reaction, it's true respect. I respect him. I'm lucky. I really am lucky. I carry such wonderful memories of Pardesi. The way he conceived the song, the way he decided on my outfit, the way he encouraged me with this tattoo business that I did, myself. It was us working together. And I will not forget how beautifully Manish made my costume, Manish Malhotra. You know, when everything falls into place, every single thing, the production, the direction, the dress, the costume, the music, the choreographer, the co-stars, Amir. Oh my God. It's a treat to work with people like Amir. Karishma, lovely girl. Suresh Ji, Oberoi. It was a coming together of everything that was beautiful. And like Dharmesh Ji says, I agree completely. The scene that I did after the song, that scene, even till now, at this age, I'm 64, even today, wherever I go, anywhere, they all universally say, Kalpana ji, wo dialogue boliye na. Pardesi gana to hai, it is a fabulous song, but dialogue. And to speak those lines is very tough for me, is because it was an exercise in perfection to shoot that scene. Because I was surrounded by people who were perfect. Dharmesh Ji, Amir, Mr. W.B. Rao, how can I forget look at the way the song was picturized. How can it be possible without speaking about the one who shot the song? It was a complete coming together of everything that's beautiful. And I will always, always, always remember Dharmesh with so much of love and affection. And you speak to him, tell him.
I'm sure you'll give some credit to Usha Uttup and Bappi Lahiri for your popularity.
Some credit? All the credit. Bakery, cake, everything. Ice cream, everything. Bolte na, cake, bakery, baker, sab kuch. It's Bappi Lahiri and Usha Iyer. Let's just get that sorted. If it was not for Bappi Das music, and if it was not for Usha Iyer singing, whom will I have danced to? Mere jitne gaane, jitne, including my very first romantic song is Bappi Lahiri. All my songs were composed by Bappi, sung by Usha ji, and I had danced. As a matter of fact, people used to say, ye to Trimurti hai. Mm-hmm. And I love it. And I still am connected to them emotionally and otherwise. They are a part of who I am. Like, aaj bhi agar mujhe koi bolega, ki Kalpana tumhari kahani mein kaun fit hota hai sabse pehle, so these are the two people. Because one sang, one gave the music. How could I have even existed without them? They are everything, everything. And I love them both. I respect them both. And as far as I'm concerned, they are very much part of my life. And I'm not being diplomatic, okay? I really do love them.
You know, this morning when I was going through your songs, I realized it's not just the music or lyrics, but all your songs have a very unique and interesting costume. And some of them are quite dramatic, and you carried all of them so well. So which is the costume or the song that you had enjoyed flaunting?
All of them. I liked all of them. Because you see, when I came into the business, first and foremost though, initially people thought I was too thin. Then thin became in. Then it became this, that Western kapde pehne hai, she has very long legs. So the max, I was in top heavy, I was leg, all about legs. I knew all these things. And the dress designer who worked with me, God bless his soul, he isn't alive, Alan Gill, he created some of the most iconic masterpieces of mere time ka. Jitne aap mere kapde aap dekhenge, most of the concentration has always been on my legs. Kyunki you only flaunt what you have. How do you flaunt what you don't have? For my time, I was considered very bold. But today, I can't say that anymore. Because in comparison to what it is today, I feel like a nun. And I'm not being mean, I'm not being nasty, I'm just being truthful. And I love each one of them. Like the outfit that was made for Hari Om Hari, it was copied from a calendar. A beautiful calendar. And that costume is truly iconic. I love the costume. It was made out of cords, colored cords. Then the costume that was made for Kudrat was made out of... Chetan Saab didn't want a light costume. He wanted the costume to feel heavy. So those beads were really heavy, real crystal. They were so heavy. My costume was... I think my costume weighed more than I did.
Really?
Yes. But then he was very, very, very sure what he wanted. And it was a beautiful costume. Similarly, all the costumes that I have worn over the years, I think that apne time ke liye, they were all very, very creative and I enjoyed them all.
Even Ramba.
Yes, those grass skirts. Those grass skirts belong to me. I had bought them from Fiji, from a carnival. And those are the kind of skirts that people wore in carnivals. So all my costumes, even in Arman, that other song, the dress costume of Aamiri Jaisi Haseena. It's the cover of Boney M, the record. When you're thin and when you know, it doesn't look vulgar and you can carry it off. And because of my modeling and my experience, my posture was right. Mm-hmm. And like I said, it used to always be tangy. So I enjoyed it. And what's not to enjoy? Yeah. Something that is mine. I didn't have to worry about being padded up. So lovely.
How tall are you?
I'm 5'5".
And you still wore those high heels?
Oh boy, let's not even go there. Yes, I was 5'5", then I wore those 4-inch heels and they were patla. And oh my God. lots of things one has done. Bahut papad bele bhai. And maze ke papad bele. No complaints.
We've spoken a lot about your songs and dances. But as an actress and amongst your films, which is that one scene that you had enjoyed the most or had found challenging?
Difficult question to answer because Bhojpuri films I did quite a bit. And I did a Bhojpuri film called Godhna, which had a very interesting role, very beautiful role. And again, a Bhojpuri film called Senurva Bhayal Mohal. I was the heroine in both the Bhojpuri movies. But the movie in Hindi that I did, which my role was a good role, but the film didn't do very well, was a film called Ameer Aadmi Gareeb Aadmi, in which I had a role as Kara Khan's wife. Mm-hmm. And it was a very beautiful role. It was a good role. And like they say, but when a movie doesn't do well, people don't notice anything. But that remains in my heart as a good role. I can't speak of anything else because most of them were dances. And the roles were all, most of them were like those negative vamp kind of roles. But the role that takes the cake, the bakery and everything, as far as I'm concerned, and to me, as much as I love and respect Dharmesh, on the same page, se thoda, I can say, idhar is Mr. Rahul Rawal. I don't think Anjaam could have come at a better time in my life. And I don't think that I can say enough thank yous to Rahul ji for this.
That was a very powerful role.
It was a very powerful role and it was written beautifully and he did complete justice to what he said he would. When he spoke to me about Anjaam, I had goosebumps the first day and I had goosebumps on the last day. And to my immense delight, it remains one of my most favorite films. It doesn't matter how well or how not well the film did. It makes no difference to me.
Recently, you had posted this picture of Dilip Kumar giving you an award. So can you tell us something about it?
I won the Lions Award in Delhi 6 years in a row for being the best dancer of the year.
Oh.
Yes. And one of the years, the trophy was given to me by Dilip Saab. And one of the years, it was given to me by Gyani Zail Singh Saab. So, both aren't alive, but these are memories I carry very dear to my heart, Divya. And I do get very emotional when I speak about these things, because these are the things that you remember. These are the things you cherish.
So, you are one of those blessed ones who Dilip Kumar has directed. Which film was that?
He was making a film for Mr. Sudhakar Bokari called Kalinga. And there were lots of stars and actors in it. I don't remember a lot of it. All I remember is my role because it came to me at a time when I could have done with what he offered me. And when he spoke to me, the way he spoke to me, the way he narrated the role, the way he even mentioned my name in the movie was Sirumai. And I think Surmai is such a beautiful name. And I was extremely, extremely thin at that point of time. And he didn't want me to put on any weight because he wanted the role, me to be the way I was. Mm-hmm. And I love the costumes he had made for me. And we went to Mysore. And I still remember the wonderful, wonderful meals Sairaji used to put on the table. The grace and the elegance and the beautiful table settings and the way the food used to be laid out and such decent, lovely people, such etiquette and such class. I miss it all. I miss it all. I remember it with such fondness. And I am blessed. I am blessed. How many people can say this? How many people to have sat and had a meal with him, to have had a cup of chai with him, to have been directed by him, to be in his presence. How lucky am I? How very lucky am I?
I know you enjoy music and I know you also sing. So can I request you to end my chat with just a few lines?
Which song should I sing? Ajeeb daasta hai, kahan shuru kahan khatam, ye manzile hai kaun si, na wo samajh sake na hum. प्यासे प्यासे दिल में है अरमा हजारों, सांसों में है सपने हजार, एक एक पल यहाँ झूम के जी ले, जीने के हैं दिन बस चार. Dreams are so many, desires never ending, life's too short, let's live, love every moment, make your life worth living. Hari Om Hari, Hari Om Hari.
Wow, that was really nice. Once again, thank you so much for coming to my show. It was wonderful chatting with you.
You're welcome, Divya. And it was wonderful talking to you. God bless you. Take care.
Bye.